Rosanna Martin was a witch who dwelt in Amesbury. With brilliant eyes, Aussie tongue, she worked her sorcery. Went into the judge's court, the sheriff brought her hither. The lilacs drooped as she passed by, and then were seen to wither. A witch she was, though trim and neat, with comely head held high. It did not seem that one as she was Satan, so would by. And when in court the afflicted ones proclaimed her evil ways, she laughed aloud and boldly then met Cotton Mather's gaze. "Who hath bewitched these maids?" he asked. Strong was her reply. "If they be dealing in black arts, you know as well as I." And then the stricken ones made moan as she approached near. They saw her shape upon the beam, so none could doubt 'twas there. The neighbors round swore to the truth of her satanic power, that she could fly o'er land and stream and come dry shod through showers. At night 'twas said she had appeared, a cat of fearsome mien. "Avoid she devil," they all cried, "to keep their spirits clean." Spectral evidence was weighed, and stern the parson spoke. "Thou shalt not suffer a witch to live, 'tis written in the book." Susanna Martin, so accused, spoke with flaming eyes. "I scorn these things, for they are not but filthy gossip's lies." Now those bewitched, they cried her out, and loud their voice did ring. They saw a bird above her head, an evil yellow thing. And so beneath the summer sky, Susanna Martin died. And still in scorn she faced the rope, her comely head held high.